StockCar Show. We're here live every Thursday night. I'm Jamie the Water Girl, and the guys over here, they're going to venture to talk some outrageous, uncensored sports tonight. It's Nick the Saint and special guest host Dave McFarland, the Iceman. So give it up for him. We'll be right back.
Cracking. We're going to get to it right away. We're going to get cracking. Folks, welcome back to the Wateboys Sports Show. Yours truly, your big bad tattooed freak daddy, St. Nick Custalow, back in the house, along with my fill-in co-host this week, filling in for the absent prophet, Paul Donkey. He is none other than our big NHL aficionado, also huge Husky fan, and pretty much knowledgeable on just about every sport out there. He is the one and only Iceman Dave McFarland. Welcome back, friend. That's right, man.
Ooh, that,
did you say back and pinch all at the same sentence there?
I guess I did. Pinch that back.
You said back up.
Pinch.
Ooh, you never want to back it up. You never want to pinch it off and back it up.
Oh, yeah, no. That's very doggy.
You can call yourself health problems like that.
Yeah, cut it off. Get some scissors out.
And of course, folks, we do have the lovely and talented Stock Car Scott.
Yes.
She was ready for this. I'm just kidding. Jamie with the Water Girl is
here
with us. And StockCar Scott over there prepping for his 15 seconds of fame, as it were. So, anyhow, folks, we've got a lot to talk about tonight, obviously. Shaq Diesel gone to the East Coast,
Miami. Turning up the heat.
Our new Brian in the booth is ecstatic because he is a Miami Heat fan, and he's just loving
Shaq in Florida.
Going back to Florida. Uh-huh. South Beach, man. Let me tell you. Oh, could I tell you some stories about South Beach? First time I
went there.
I went there
a little over a year ago for some friends'
it's
wedding.
A good time.
Ooh, man.
We were in Boynton Beach and Boynton Beach.
That's right. It was a good time.
Anyhow, we took a trip down to South Beach. First thing I saw as I walked onto South Beach was titties. That's right.
Nice.
Three sets of them, yo.
And he just kept looking.
Three sets of them. And I'm talking like, you know, nudist colony. Oh, my God. Look at all the rolls on that girl. She looks like a bread factory. No, I'm talking like
a bread factory.
I'm like talking,
bam.
Damn, I usually got to have like a pocket full of singles and paying a cover charge to see that. And here I am on the beach getting it for free. Woo! Yeah, that kind of titty. So, yeah, it was a good time. South Beach is hit, man. It's just
so you recommend
it's like it's Caribbean, you know what I mean? It's so influenced
of course
by
he recommends
the Latinos
it.
And the
true.
Caribbeans and the Haitians.
Why wouldn't he?
Oh, Lord have mercy. It's nice. Speaking of nice, you know what? If you want the complete antithesis as far as women, but that's a tip. Yeah, I just got
the antithesis.
Just as far as weather goes or as location geography goes, got back from Vancouver Tuesday, spent the weekend up in Vancouver.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord. Oh, does the saint love himself some Vancouver Canadian ham? Boy, I'm all ready to say oot and a boot. Mm-hmm. Hey. I'm ready to change over, man. Day. Become an expatriate and move to Canada. Yeah, yo, you know. I already got a roots. I got my roots beret. You know?
Do you know you actually get paid well to be down on a station like this down there? Paid like
$65,000
a year.
You discussed about that guy that was Mike Meyer, works with Mike Meyer's brother.
Yeah,
on the show
Patrick
up there.
Malia.
But see, that's the thing,
Patrick.
Is they probably got to get hired up there on public access as opposed to here where any old freak can walk in off the street
and get
a show.
Yeah, I did it tonight.
Right.
Oh. So did I.
So anyhow, folks, we got a lot of stuff to get to. Obviously, we got the prizes.
Chris
McAsee. Here's the deal. We got a new rule because we're having problems getting these prize packages out to people. And believe me, I don't mind pulling the shit back in and giving it out the next week, because all we do is the following week, we add something else to it. Now, if I call your name and you aren't watching and you miss out, I'll be nice enough to put your name back in the hat. However, if you're going to be out of town, you know, and you're going to miss one week's show and you know it, the wisest thing to do is either call the voicemail or email us and tell us, hey, you know, I'm not going to be there this week. I don't want my name to get called and miss out on my chance to win the prize, so pull my name out of the hat so I don't miss out on it. However, if you do, we will throw it back in there, but your chances of winning it again are
pretty
slim. And I'm not going to have, like, Chris, you're in the hopper, but if your name gets called again tonight, your number, I'm telling Jamie to pick a different number. It's just that simple. I'm not going to give you 2 weeks in a row. You're going to have to wait.
Nope.
So I'm making rules as I go along. You're damn right. I probably should have done all this beforehand, but I'm figuring out as I go along.
Breaking them.
And the fact is I'm giving you free stuff. You don't have to pay a damn thing. All you've got to do is watch the Wateboys. That's it.
That's enjoyment.
Watch the Wateboys.
If you're enjoying it.
So to enter, you can go to thewaterboys2002@yahoo.com. and leave your information. I want your full name. Hello, people out there calling the voicemail line. Jazz or Jason, whatever the fuck
be
your name
nice.
Is. My favorite athlete is, you know. Dude, your
Bob with one O.
Full name. That means first and last. And your phone number.
Slow
and your
down.
Favorite athlete. And please, folks, try to put the bongs and the beer down before you call me and have somewhat of a
slob.
Yeah, do that during the show.
Try to have some continuity and you know,
or vice versa.
Build up
ability
to
speak. I mean, well, no, they're sitting there going, dude, come on.
Yeah.
Sober
Spit
up.
Spit it out
call,
and
okay?
then hit it.
I'm just like a lot more likely to put your name in the hopper if
not
I'm
to be personal or
not
anything,
annoyed
you know?
All to hell by your call.
Exactly.
You know, if you're too messed up to do it that way, just email us. That way I can't hear your annoying ass
stumbled
out
letters.
Voice. Okay. So anyhow, if you want to do that, you go to the email, thewaterboys2002@yahoo, or you can call the voicemail number 206-627-13. Yeah, see, they'll throw all that information up on the screen for you there. Anyhow, that's what you got to do. First and last name.
They're not going to want to
your
now.
Phone number and your favorite athlete of all
now
time.
Now there's too much
when
pressure.
When in doubt, spell it out.
Jamie, just so you know, I have
just
17.
So you know.
17 tonight, so
work your way
through
like
a number,
magazine.
Figure 17. Out a number, and you know, you'll get back to me about halfway through the show, about the time you're done.
I'll get back to you when I get back to you when I figure out what my number's gonna be. How's that?
Right. I got a good number for you. 68. You do me and I owe you one.
Yeah. The number only goes to 17, remember? It only goes to 17. Sorry.
What's that?
Only goes to 17.
Only goes to 17?
Yeah.
Okay, let's
nice
see.
Try.
17 divided into 68.
Yeah, you could do the
four.
Six,
hey,
or you could do the
times,
nine.
Four times, that's right.
You
can give me four times, and I owe you one.
Oh, so you're
four times 17. Because 4 times 17 is 68.
What a bargain.
You do really fast math.
How quick was my math?
What a bargain.
Not very quick.
That's called East Coast 70s, 80s education there.
Yeah.
That's from the South.
It's from the gangster rap.
Some of that.
Yeah.
Nation education.
So, folks, if you'd like to join us tonight live in the studio, of course, there's always a way to do that. The number 206-421-5658. 421-5659. We've got about, 2 months? Not even that. Not even that. A month and a half before football season is underway.
Woo.
I mean, look, come on. I love baseball.
Hey,
women's basketball is like tennis and golf. I don't watch it, but when I hear about it, I go, "Who? Oh, okay."
Hey, you know I've said it before. Fall time. Well, I love summer. Love my summertime.
Uh-huh.
I really love summer too.
Right.
But summer's got to come to an end. And when it does, and you're starting to get a little sad that the sun's starting to go away,
there's Labor Day.
Guess
weekend.
What?
I know.
Guess what? That's when football starts and hockey starts. So that is the
nothing
ease
like Labor Day weekend,
into summer
man.
Leaving. That's what helps you with summer leaving is football season
love
and hockey season.
Yeah, that really
Labor
doesn't
Day
help me
time.
Much.
Monday
Labor
night
Day
football.
Weekend. You get Labor Day
Woo.
Weekend. You get Sunday football and then Monday night football. Oh, yeah. Okay. Hey,
I go from shorts
did I tell you last
into
time?
Sweats.
Did I just got the hookup? The 411 on tickets for the Notre Dame game.
A lot
games?
Of girls don't even shave.
Did you know?
I'm going, baby.
Right on.
Yeah, me and wife are going. And
south to South Bend.
It's gonna be good.
Indiana.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Tear it up. Party on down.
Touchdown.
Dogs.
Party.
Touchdown.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Who said party?
Gotta get a little touch on there.
Praise God.
We're gonna hook it up.
Jesus
so
rules.
It's gonna be good.
That. Jesus rules. So anyhow, you can join
bonus.
Us in the studio tonight.
We should have a summer blowout party.
God, man. Where do we go from here? We got the Mariners, obviously. They sent John Olerud down. We got Shaquille O'Neal going to Miami. We got Kobe remaining in Los Angeles. I still think that the West is wide open now. But here's an issue I have real quick on the NBA, Dave. The the talk has been just ad nauseum. Oh, we're talking about Shaq going to Miami and, you know, Kobe staying here. And, oh, what does that do to the Lakers? And who in the West is the favorite to win it now? And, oh, it's got to be San Antonio. They just signed Brett Barry from the Sonics. And, you know, blah, blah, blah. And, on, and Karl Malone might potentially go to San Antonio now that Shaq's gone. And, you know, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And I ask you folks, did anyone here watch the NBA Finals?
Anybody?
Did anyone happen to see
anyone?
That team from the East
Bueller?
Called Detroit Bueller? Just bitch slap the Los Angeles Lakers around the floor for five games? I mean, why is it? I mean, it's just so funny to me how dismissive it seems the whole sports world is about the Detroit
bitch.
Pistons. Thank you. The Detroit is a little late, but that's okay. You're getting there.
We're working
on hard. The Detroit Pistons are just like this, just forgotten. They just smoked the favorite in the NBA.
They're still talking about L.A. all over again. Like, let's go back to L.A.
Like anybody gives a shit about L.A. Yep. I'm sorry. I'm sick of L.A. Done. Yep. Fork in them, okay? Done with L.A. The Detroit Pistons have proven that they can beat the hell out of any team in the NBA.
They check their egos.
Now Kenyon Martin is leaving New Jersey and going to Denver, and depending on what New Jersey does to make up for that loss, you're looking at Detroit potentially, Detroit and depending on what Indiana does, being the two elites in the East.
True.
Detroit might be the next dynasty for all we know with Ben Wallace.
That's right.
Rasheed Wallace is potentially going to re-sign
you'll hear
there.
Those guys
Richard Hamilton, you know, Chauncey Billups. I mean, and if they pick up a good draft pick or free agents, depending on what they do in free agency, I mean, there's no stopping this team from repeating again next year. Because
who doesn't want to go to a good team?
I mean, granted, San Antonio has the potential, obviously. I think it would have been a better finals had it been San Antonio in the finals. But, you know, we'll never know. It didn't happen.
It didn't make it.
But the fact is you've got Detroit there with the crown, and it just seems like everybody's dismissing them, just kind of forgotten about them, wants to talk about, you know, and I understand it's the story, you know, the breakup of the, you know, the big dynasty in L.A.
The shakeup.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. The fact is that the Sonics haven't gotten any better because of it. So what difference does it make?
What are we getting out of it? I mean,
what difference does it make? You know. So anyhow, speaking of what difference does it make, we sent John Olerud down. We're designating for assignment, which basically means go down to Tacoma and play ball if you want to play. And John, being the nice Christian fellow that he is being very diplomatic about it, very well-spoken, but he just wants to play. He had the desire to retire, to end his career in Seattle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We stated earlier before the show, well, fine, your career's ended in Seattle.
Yeah.
There you go.
Here it is.
Well,
thank you.
But no, we've got Bucky Jacobson. We've got Justin Leone. We've got these young kids in Tacoma that obviously need an opportunity to show what they're worth.
Bucky's been doing real good down there, so we'll see what we can do at this level.
Absolutely, and it's time to bring them up and see what they can do. We're bringing the pitchers up to see what they've got since Freddie's gone. Let's bring up the batters. Bucky Jacobson's been lighting it up, so there's no reason not to let that kid come up and at least show what he's got.
It's nice first game with him, right?
It is. Yeah. It is. Playing the Cleveland Indians as we speak.
Ooh.
So we will find out, hopefully, from one of our loyal viewers who has Pitcher and Pitcher calling us to let us know what the
Pitcher and Pitcher.
What the score is. And I believe, is it CeCe Sabathia pitching against them tonight? It is. It is. CeCe's on my fantasy team, so that's why I care. So I'm hoping the Mariners just get smoked, like, you know, like 7-0, you know? I mean, hell, they've been scoring all season. Now all of a sudden, you want me to like wish that they'd scored? No, not when my fantasy pitcher's out there. No, I want them to go. I want them to put up the big goose egg.
They lost this many games. They can lose another.
I know. I just want them to put up the big goose egg for nine innings. You know, maybe one hit, if that. You know,
Omar Vizquel.
Okay with that.
Another nice guy we let go, right?
12 strikeouts. Is that out too much? 12 strikeouts. Yeah.
Another guy we're glad we let go.
Omar Scott Podsednik. You know, Derek Lowe, Jason Varitek. By the way, speaking of Derek Lowe. Derek Lowe would be part of a four-man rotation if things work out between Arizona and Boston. That just has to strike fear into the hearts of the evil empire.
Fear.
Randy Johnson, albeit progressed in age, yes, we understand that, but still throwing smoke, still arguably one of the best pitchers in the game.
Yeah,
pitches his ass off in Arizona for a team that just does not give him any run support. Sounds like another team we know from the West.
That's too bad, too. He needs the fame.
But if he goes to Boston, and plays for the Boston Red Sox, you're looking at Pedro Martinez, Curt Schilling, Randy Johnson, and Derek Lowe. And you're talking about a five-game series? Is it still five games in the wild card? The divisional?
I believe
right?
so. Yeah,
the divisional is still five games. So you're talking about facing those four. Yeah. And if you wanted to set
That's
your weak link down,
lineup.
Obviously you're going to set your weak link, which is Derek Lowe, right?
Yeah.
So, okay, so pick your poison. Randy Johnson, Pedro Martinez, or Curt Schilling. Which one's it going to be? Who do you want?
The lose-lose situation?
Who do you want, huh? I mean,
Doesn't
obviously,
matter.
Pedro has struggled a bit at times. I think Randy Johnson is just chomping on the bit for an opportunity to pitch in the big lights of New York and Boston, you know, on the big scene. He loves that.
Yeah.
Look what he did in the playoffs for Arizona when they won that, you know, that a couple
true.
Years ago. So,
yep.
I'm just, man, the thought of it just, whoo.
Man.
And we're still waiting for the Seattle Mariners. God bless them for bringing up the young kids, but we're still waiting as they're letting all these talented, quote-unquote, talented veterans go. We're still waiting for them to bring in. We're waiting for a trade. Something.
Yeah,
some substantial trade.
Spend some money.
Well, the thing is they're spending money. The only problem is that the money they've spent has been on players who are now really sucking. And what it is, whether it's mental, if it's the batting, the hitting coach,
horrible scouting,
if it's just a lack of confidence in their manager, I don't know. If it's just some curse that Seattle has.
They do have that curse.
I mean, we could.
The curse
we
that
could
we suck?
Be,
Come on.
Folks,
curse.
We
you don't
could,
have that curse,
we could
Seattle.
Be touching
pick it
on something here. We could be touching on something here, very legitimate, that the Seattle Mariners have a curse on them that we haven't quite figured
it's
out. Maybe it's the kid curse, the curse of the kid.
Could be.
You
know?
Could
be.
Yeah,
right.
I mean, obviously, we went to the playoffs. We went to the American League Championship Series after A-Rod and the kid
lost,
and Johnson left, the unit
there.
Left.
Yeah.
But we've never done anything.
That's true.
We had 116 wins. You get your ass kicked.
Record,
you get your ass kicked by the Yankees
that
in the ALCS.
Man.
I mean, you know, Arthur Rhodes out there just throwing up meatballs for him. Here you go. Here you go.
Serve it up.
So, I mean, I don't know if that's what we're looking at now, but we're also looking at the Seahawks. The Seahawks, it's just something. Maybe, you know what? I bet it is. I bet it's Indian burial ground that the stadiums are built on.
There it is, right there.
They built the extra stadium on there.
They amplified the curse.
Yeah, really, yep.
So now you've got it in Seahawks Stadium, Quest Field. And you've got it in Safeco Field. I mean, sucks. No, I'm sorry.
I bet so.
Mariner Stadium, Seahawks Stadium. That's what I'm calling
that's
from now.
What I call it.
I refuse, from now
that's
on, I refuse to call these stadiums by their corporate names because the corporate name could change in the
what
next
a joke.
Year.
Yep.
We don't know.
It's
kind of
like the Key Arena. Well, I've kind of still called it that, but I still like to call it the Coliseum.
Coliseum, Seattle Center Coliseum.
Yeah. I mean, really like the lighting on the outside of the stadium.
I saw Metallica and the Cult there. I saw Queensryche on New Year's Eve there.
I just
love it. I'm sorry, Jamie, what were you saying?
I was saying maybe it's because I'm a girl. I don't know. I really like the coloring that they put on the outside of the Seahawks Stadium. I think that really adds a nice touch.
You know, I was
noticing
that as the sun was starting to go down and the reflection across the sky, and I looked over the stadium, the beautiful colors, and I really had to take time to take it all in. And
thank you.
Kind of running behind her.
Thank you, Iceman.
Did I just say that? Dude, is the camera on me?
Dude, are you?
That's a quote from Half Baked almost.
Camera on me.
Do you have a vagina?
I was looking the other way. I didn't see the sky at all.
My God. I thought those were pecs. Jeez. Come here. Let me touch your nipples, honey.
You
got
to see the movie.
So, folks, if you'd like to join us, hey, Al, how are we doing on phone calls there?
We have one.
We have a holding caller?
We do. Okay. Well, before we get to our first commercial break, let's go over to Jamie, see who our caller is. And we got to get the voicemails in. I know.
Let's hear who our caller is and see who our caller is.
Jamie, who's on the phone?
I don't think we can see who our caller is. I think we're just going to be able to hear him tonight.
Play on words.
It's Dave from Lake City. He might be able to be seen. I don't know.
Dave, what's up, buddy?
How you doing,
Hey, Jamie, Nick,
how are
and
you?
Ice Cube.
Hey, today is a good day.
Hey, Nick.
Yes, sir.
I was watching the news tonight.
You were?
Somebody was leaving the Mariners.
Somebody was leaving the Mariners?
Yeah, some baseball player.
Yeah, his name is John.
Oh, John Olerud, leaving the Mariners.
Johnny Old Dude.
I saw that on the news tonight, and he was giving a speech.
Yeah.
But the news say he is a great baseball player.
He is.
Yep.
Or was.
And then he was telling
a great person.
And then he was telling everybody on TV he wasn't.
Well,
that's because he's bashful.
He hasn't been as of late.
Yeah, past couple of years he's dropped a little.
Did he cry during his speech?
Very modest.
His talent has dropped off, you know? Kind of like as you get
like
older
this.
And the old prostate starts to go on you, Dave, you know? And
yeah.
You just can't
like
seem to get to going to Kansas
like
City.
You get the bat up.
And it's like that.
You know what I'm talking about? You're kind of looking at me with like a certain,
that?
You know, recognition of what I'm saying
like
here.
That.
You understand what I'm talking about? Okay, Al's
you,
with
you
me
know,
on this.
You know who was my favorite pitcher?
The prostate gets bigger. The bat gets smaller. Doesn't seem to quite
the
work the way it
used to. The wood and the bat isn't quite.
Yeah. You
the big unit.
What's that?
A big unit, Rodney Johnson.
Oh, we're talking about big units?
Yeah.
Man, that was a great segue.
I like him.
You should do TV.
He's a good pitcher.
He is.
Hey, I got 19 more days before I leave on my trip.
Right on, man.
So my birthday's coming up, so don't forget David's birthday.
We won't
forget birthdays are coming up.
We won't forget
When's
David's
birthday.
August the 4th.
The Leo. Dave the Leo.
And I'm coming down with a cake. We're going to have cake.
That's right, Dave.
Okay.
All right, buddy. Well,
bye,
we'll talk
Mr. Ice Cube.
We'll talk to you soon.
Say goodbye,
Greg.
David.
Bye, David.
Bye, Ice Cube.
Dave.
Bye.
Notice he didn't try to say sock star Scott.
Yeah, well.
Yeah. You are a sock
busy
star.
Busy talking
yeah,
to Ice Cube.
You are. Totally tubular. You are the total sock star.
That
the socks
Ice
are totally
Cube.
Tubular.
Yeah, totally tubular.
I like the way he jerks him up to his knees like he's playing soccer. Dude, that's so cool.
Yeah, we love Dave from Lake City, and we hope you have a wonderful birthday and trip
right.
to Disneyland.
Hey,
are we ready?
Left off in the support.
Hey, maybe. Man in the booth, do we want to run the voicemails right now?
Did you say
or
booth?
Do we want to? Okay, voicemails are ready to go. Okay, folks, here it is. Real quick, we're going to run with them. This week's installments of the Wateboys voicemails. Hit it.
Come on, man. I'm running with it. Let's go.
Rolling.
Sport sucks.
Keep rolling.
Should I run slower?
We're waiting.
We're still waiting. Anticipating.
And now, this week's installments of the Wateboys voicemails.
Bingo.
Go to the playoffs this year. This next year, so might as well build for the future. First white guy ever taken out of high school. That's pimpin'. Straight pimpin'. Another thing I was going to say is people like John Olerud that turned down a trade and haven't been earning their money the last few years. I figure if you haven't been earning your money the last few years, you're no trade clause to get thrown out the window. What do you think about that? He should do it for the betterment of our team. He knows he hasn't been earning his money. He should just take what he's made, which is basically winning the lottery, go to Boston and deal with it.
Deal with it. That's right. What do you got to say about that?
Two.
Hey, Nick. Hey.
Saved. Message.
It's a personal.
Three.
Hey, Nick.
Thursday.
Deleted.
Are your friends call?
Message. Four.
Hey, Nick.
Yeah, I love the show. Got to hear some more. Sean from Ren. Hit me back up. My favorite sports player is Hasselbeck, of course. My Hasselbeck. Seahawks, baby.
Saved.
That's what I was talking about.
How you doing, Sean?
A little more. You
yeah,
know,
put me down with Paul. I have no tattoos. And I've never seen Titanic.
And you have
never.
Trouble with the English language, but that's okay.
Deleted. Message. Six.
Welcome to the club.
Hey. You guys haven't even talked about Seattle's newest team.
I know.
The Rat City Roller Girls. The new roller derby team. Coming to town. They had a special fundraiser tonight at the Crocodile.
Yeah, we don't know anything about it, man. You have to call some
Dallas. Get on top of that. Check that stuff out.
We can get those girls on this show. Believe me, I will get on top
Deleted.
Of that.
I bet they're hot, too.
Whoa.
Message.
Roll them in.
Roller derby.
Seven.
Roller skates.
Rat City Roller Girls.
Hey, guys. This is Dave from South Park. Thanks for having me on the show again. It was really cool. Thank you, Jamie, for shaking that final laugh.
Deleted. Message. Eight.
You're welcome.
Hey, what's up, freak? I like taped your show tonight. Actually, I had like my girlfriend tape your show. And it was like so cool how you had to start off with that guy with the afro. He was like tattooing somebody's butt. And then
that was my
butt. His
butt
had poo all over it and it got all over his needle.
I'm just kidding.
It really
wasn't
cool.
That was not
deleted.
Me.
Is
that Beavis?
End of
but
saved messages.
Than that.
Yes.
You
okay.
have.
Okay.
Okay. That was cool.
Fire.
She had like pull all over.
Light that bug's butt on fire.
That's cool.
Okay, anyhow, we're running out of time here. Folks, we're
going to
break up the monotony here a little bit. We will take more of your phone calls, 421-565-8-5659. live on the Wateboys Sports Show right
live,
after our
live,
first
live.
Commercial break. Jamie's going to take you out, and when we come back, we're going to
take you out back.
We're going to give you a little eye candy, as it were, and we're going to give some prizes away. So stick around. Remember, if you're on the list, if you entered the contest, you have to be watching the show.
You can't
to
grease
win.
The doorman to be on the
you,
list.
To verify that, you need to call the voicemail or email within the next 24 hours. Before, or at least before next Thursday's show, and tell
get
me who
done.
Your favorite athlete is, because I got all of your favorite athletes there, so I know who you are.
Take care of business.
Okay? So, on that note, here's Jamie, and we'll see you in just a few minutes. Enjoy.
That's right, and if you do get a chance to grease up any doorman, I would definitely recommend doing that. And now we'll be back in like 3 minutes. That might even give you a chance to do just that. And I'm not sure what the commercial break is. Something that you probably need parental discretion, though. So enjoy, be careful, and we'll be right back. Enjoyed that clip from Scary Movie 1, 2, 3, whatever it was. Either way, I was scared. She was hot, and you're back. And give it up for the host over there, Snick the Saint, and Ice Cube. Yeah, Ice Cube over there. Live from the house, man. I'm Jamie Wateboys. Give it up for him, though.
What the hell? It was a good game.
Yeah.
You got to look at the
fuck the police, and Ice Cube said it with authority. Because
yeah,
a brother
did.
In the hood is a minority. A majority, excuse me.
Oh.
Sorry. I haven't listened to NWA in a while. I'm kind of slipping on my lyrics. Sorry.
Freudian slip.
Have to drop folks, yeah. Welcome back to Wateboys Sports Show. Thank you, freaks, for putting the bongs down long enough to give us the clap.
Just long enough.
If you'd like to join us, 421-5658, 421-5659. You can also enter the contest, thewaterboys2002 at yahoo.com.
Yes,
or
you should do
call
that.
The number 206-600-2713. Leave your full name. That's first and last phone
call
number.
Me.
And favorite athlete of all time. Anyhow, Jamie,
us.
I guess before we get into the funk break here, I told you earlier we have 17 lucky individuals tonight entered into the contest.
17, yes.
Uh-huh. Have you decided on a number yet?
Yeah.
Have you?
I'm just going to go with a random number.
Uh-huh.
Random.
Number 9.
Number 9.
Who wins?
Wow. That's just what I was projecting.
Lucky little
over
bastard.
To.
By the way,
lucky little bastard.
If you are watching Lucky Number 9, number
you
got
to call us.
Nine, you have
verify
to call.
You heard
I know
us.
This guy's probably watching. You called and left us your address and everything, and I got 184. I didn't get the rest of it, of your address, so because I had written it down somewhere else and that piece of paper got on, so I remembered 184 or something another, Linden Avenue. So anyhow, you need to call us anyhow to claim your prizes. Keith Roberts, congratulations, my
Keith
friend.
Keith Roberts,
have won
I have selected your
tonight.
Name, Keith, personally.
By the way, Sound Sensational,
you.
Curtis Shepard from Sound Sensational, our buddy down there off 25618 Pacific Highway South, has been kind enough to hook the Wateboys up once again. Keith, not only do you win the starter set from Major League Baseball MLB Clicks, courtesy of WizKids over in Bellevue, and the Ichiro doll and the
action figure
Palm Pilot PDA wallet there.
Jeez.
And the autographed John Olerud picture.
Oh, the
these
stuff
things
you
which
won.
Have been sitting here for this is the third week we tried to give it away now. You also get a set of 6x9 Pioneer car stereo speakers, 220 watts max. I forget what the RMS is, and $90 retail value for those. So I guess a prize package here, if I were to try to put a number on it, I'd say well over $250. Is that worth entering the contest, people?
I think so.
Is that
that's
worth
right.
Is that worth watching
that
the Wateboys Sports Show?
That is a bargain
for 1 hour on your miserable Thursday night to watch the Wateboys
and the Water Girl.
That's right. So speaking of which, starting in September, the new season starts. We will be moving
the
to 8:30. So make sure you make a note of it in your day planner
this
in your
fall.
Schedule.
Live,
we're moving
live,
to 8:30. It'll be still be an hour show, 8:30 to 9:30, but we will be on a half hour earlier.
Increments.
So we'll be coming on for you a half hour earlier.
Oh.
Sure,
that's
most
right.
Of you are used.
Play on words.
We'll be
you.
Coming
I'm sure most of you are used to it by
half
now.
Hour earlier.
In the meantime,
just half an hour earlier.
You know, let's see. We've got NASCAR going up. I want to get into this Casey Kane thing where Tony Stewart spun him out, because I know Tony Stewart is just really loved by a particular person in our studio here who just thinks Tony Stewart is the hottest.
And sets on him.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
He hates Tony Stewart.
If he called
but
90 Day
movies. I believe in the meantime, I think it's time that we give the viewers a little eye candy. Don't you, sound man?
So it's Scott's turn, you're saying?
Oh, okay.
Oh, perfect.
A little old school for you.
Gotcha.
Boys and girls, if you swing that way, and boy, we don't mind it here. Little eye candy for you. This is known as the funk break, if you will, even though it's not funk music. It's Jamie.
Old school funk.
It's the punk break. Oh, it's funk. Punk. It's a good call. Punk break with Jamie. Enjoy it, all right?
Last night, a little dancer came dancing to my door. Last night, a little angel came pumping on the floor. She said, come, baby, got a license for love. And if it expires, pray help from above. Because in the midnight hour, she cried, love, love, love. I'm there. But when it's all lonely, she sees me to bed. What set you free and brought you to me, babe? What set you free? I need you here by me. Because in the midnight hour, she cried, more, more, more. With a rebel yell, she cried, more, more.
There's like a lot of bounce there tonight.
Maybe a little bit out.
Yeah. That's okay. Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. Get your freak on. Get your freak off. Hell, what the hell? We don't mind. Welcome back,
all
folks.
Twisting part that got me.
Welcome back to the Wateboys Sports Show. That's right. Hey,
twisting part that got me.
We'll be showing you the promo again, but just for you tattooed aficionados out there, if you're into it. If you're not, that's cool too. You should come on down.
Late.
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, August 20th through the 22nd, I will be hosting the third annual Seattle Tattoo Convention. Damon Conklin from Super Genius Tattoo and Gloria Connors of Moto Productions will be putting on another fabulous event at the Seattle Center, Snoqualmie and Alki Rooms. It's a good time, 12 noon to 10 p.m., and after parties every day of the event. So, by the way, Sendog, I don't know if any of you out there are familiar with Sendog. Sendog is from Cypress Hill. I've been mentioning Cypress Hill is going to be playing. I was mistaken. Sendog from Cypress Hill will be performing Friday night, August 20th.
That's right.
At the after party. I'm not going to tell you where. If you want to know where, you're going to have to come to the tattoo convention, okay? Or you'll find out somewhere.
Be there, be square.
So. Anyhow,
in
the meantime, let's find out who our phone caller is and head over to Jamie and see. Darling, who's on the phone?
We have on the phone possibly a new viewer, possibly a new caller. I've never heard of him. It's Dre.
Is this Dre?
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Dre?
Yeah, it's Dre, man. What's going on,
yeah,
y'all?
Like,
what's up, dog?
Me.
Hey, man, I heard you on the radio the other day on Como after the game.
Oh, you heard me the other day?
Dude, you were hitting, man. I mean, I was sitting there listening to you. They gave you some time, brother. They let
hey,
you
Hey, man,
they
I'm hitting more than the Mariners, you know what I'm saying, this year because,
they,
unfortunately,
they let you
we have
speak
to...
your mind, man. I was like, you know what? I need Dre to call my show and tell him to get his ass down here on this show some night. We're going to sit down and just break it down.
Hey, man, it'd be my pleasure. Hey, anytime, man, I'm there. You know what I'm saying?
All
because,
right,
you know,
every
sports
Thursday
is what I love to do. Sports is my passion, my energy. I bring it all to the table.
I know you do,
some
man.
People
I've heard you.
Like to call, hold stuff, and
I've
ask
heard
them
you
a question.
Plenty of times.
I never do that. I leave my comments on the air. I don't take them off. And, you know, I don't let you know what city that I call from because the host does that when he goes to you. You know what I'm saying?
That's you know what
break
I'm saying?
It down like no people can break it down. And breaking it down is the Seattle Mariner management did not come through this year. And what I mean not coming through, and we wouldn't have to even talking about John Olerud if they would have got Rafael Palmeiro. We wouldn't even talking about, you know, the old boy. Dinosaur. I shouldn't
Thank
say
you.
C-3PO, John Olerud, the robot who did, who we thought maybe he would have a bounce back year. He did not do that, and we just let Edgar Martinez come back to get 300 and 500. That is it. But we had problems in the offseason that we needed to fix, and we didn't do that.
Vladimir Guerrero Dre, hold up for just a second, man. And we got a shortstop. We just got rid of Rich Aurelia, and
no,
we had
Rich,
a shortstop here. We had a shortstop here that was plenty serviceable, that is just ripping it up in Detroit now.
Ripping it up.
On a team that actually has a respectable record. Detroit. We're talking the Detroit Tigers have a better record or a more respectable team right now than the Seattle Mariners. How demoralizing is that for a Seattle Mariner fan, man?
Hey,
it's
Trey.
A slap in the face because they're all about making money. See,
that's
the
it.
Seattle Mariners,
all about
everything
money
that
now.
They've done is backfire. Jeff Cirillo came back this year, hit the home run against you to beat the win. John Mayberry hit a home run against you to win games. Everything is backfire. Griffey was healthy all year long. Yeah, unfortunately, he's got to pull his hamstring again, but still, everything is backfired against the Seattle Mariners. Bill Bavasi, I said Bill, nothing but a waste, you see, has done nothing. He's nothing but a Danny Berry with a goatee. Don't let him fool you. He's nothing but a two-bit loan shark from New York City. He didn't do nothing with the Anaheim Angels when he was the general manager
That's
for the
right.
Anaheim Angels. He
My
ain't
going
to do nothing now. You know what I'm saying?
I know, I'm with you, man.
As far as the Seahawks situation is concerned, let me just flip the script real quick to the Seahawks situation. Sean Alexander needs to step up this year. Sean Alexander needs to bounce back this year. Sean Alexander needs to get me a first down. This ain't the Jimmy Swagger telethon, Sean Alexander. This ain't the best damn sports show. You need to wake up and address 3rd and 1, 4th and 1, and get me a first down. Then we're talking about giving you an extension for your contract. And Walter Jones, yeah, you need to come back to camp this year. You need to come down to Cheney. We know you don't want to. We know you want to talk about a one-year tender, but still, does Walter Jones deserve the money? If you're going to give Grant Wisdom $14 million when his numbers have diminished, a signing bonus of $14 million when his numbers have diminished the past 3 years, 11 sacks, 9, 7, you know what I'm saying? And he had to play one down with the Seattle team. So don't tell me that
don't
Walter Jones
you.
Does not deserve more than $14 million. Right. We're going to give Grant Wisdom $14 million who didn't play one down, whose knees are probably torn up playing with Edward Jones, though. You know what I'm saying?
And Drake. Drake,
let me tell you, Keith Gilbride.
Drake, take a breath. Drake, take a breath, brother. Take a breath.
Turn your TV down just a little tiny bit.
Take a breath, man. I'm feeling you, man. I'm feeling you. No, seriously, though. I know, because you get on a roll, brother. It's, you know, somebody got to rein you in, man. I don't know if you got a woman, but she needs to put the reins on you, pull you back sometimes.
Hey, man, I'm just kicking real. I know you do. I'm not Dr. Dre, but I do got a lot of patience. But I don't have any patience dealing with the Seattle Mariners and dealing with the Seattle Seahawks. They need to address those
issues. Or the Supersonics, man. We could go. Look, you and I could do a solid month of one-hour shows without having any other segments on it talking about the demoralizing state of the Sonics, the Seahawks, and the Mariners, and the way management has ruined the city's sports structure right now.
Okay? Oh, yeah,
when we're talking about the Seattle's women's basketball team is the most exciting product on the sports scene right now in this town. I mean, that's not knocking the Seattle Storm. That's knocking those other guys out there that are getting paid a lot more money than them women to play, and they're stinking the place up. But, Dre, I'm telling you what, I'm going to give you a call back, man, and I'm going to get you on the show soon, all right?
All right, man. You take it easy.
All right, brother.
Absolutely,
take care, man.
Thanks for
calling
the show,
in.
Jay.
All right. What did you say, y'all?
All right. Something happened there. I don't know.
Yeah.
The phone broke up, man.
We love you, though, man. Definitely come on the show. We'd love to have you anytime.
Al, do we have another caller?
Something else to talk about, too.
Do we have another call? Well, you got the sign up there. Take the damn sign down. Do your damn job. Okay, in the meantime, while we are waiting for phone calls from you people out there, it's time for us to move it on over to the pits.
Moving on,
man.
It's time for us to head on over to the pits
and catch up on the world of NASCAR.
Whoosh.
49.70 on the leader. Good job. Keep it up. Go to the front.
Hey. Hey.
Tony Maroney Stewart.
Everybody needs an asshole, and Tony Stewart is NASCAR's. You know, every sport needs a bad boy, and NASCAR's is Tony Stewart. You know, let him be the bad boy. It's no big deal. You know, it helps the sport.
Well, it used to be Dale Earnhardt, didn't it?
Yeah, it used to be Dale Earnhardt. It used to be Darrell Waltrip.
Right.
It used to be Rusty Wallace. It used to be a lot of bad boys. Tim Richmond. The list goes on and on. The sport needs Tony Stewart, and it's good that he's a former champion. He's a past champion, and that backs up his bad boy, not with just stupidity, but with just actual experience, and he knows where he's coming from. But I guess y'all know what happened this weekend up in Chicago. Tony Stewart won the race, and during an incident during the race, Casey Kane, the darling of NASCAR rookies, kind of lost traction there for a second. In just that nanosecond, Tony Stewart was able to catch up with him and get all up into his butt and push him right into the wall. And then all hell broke out in the pits. I mean, I swear it was almost like a hockey game in the pits. The crew chief for Casey Kane went over to Tony Stewart's crew chief, was going to have a little word with him, got into a shoving match. Tommy Baldwin, the crew chief for Casey Kane, gets in the camera and starts yelling about what NASCAR needs to do this and NASCAR needs to do that to Tony Stewart. Well, the only one that's gotten a fine so far is Tommy Baldwin for going over into somebody else's pits where he didn't belong.
That's right.
As Confucius says, a man that fishes in another man's pond only catches crabs. But anyway, the big news this weekend, of course, last weekend, I do have to touch on one thing. Junior sucked last weekend. He finished 22nd, and he lost a lot of points to Jamie's favorite driver, Jimmy Johnson, who is now 105 points ahead of him because I think he finished second in the Chicago race. But on to this weekend. There is no major racing this weekend.
So Jimmy's behind a Johnson?
That's right. He's behind a Johnson. Anyway.
The Johnson's behind Junior.
So aren't we all behind a Johnson in a larger sense? But anyway, this weekend, the two major series are off. Busch and Nextel Cup are off this weekend. So the drivers are doing other things, like Junior is going to drive down in Sonoma, California on a road course in a Corvette. And Casey Kane is going to be in the area. He is going to be at Gray's Harbor Speedway racing an outlaw car on Saturday night. And Saturday night, Stock Car Scott and his lovely wife are going to be up at Evergreen because Evergreen
is hosting.
That's right,
ladies. He's taken.
Well, Evergreen's hosting the like the Double A series of NASCAR. The what used to be called Winston West, now it's called Grand National West. Kerry Earnhardt has gotten a ride with one of the best teams there, and we hope to see him win. That's why I'm wearing Kerry Earnhardt stuff tonight. That 12 is not for Ryan Newman. That 12 is for Kerry Earnhardt, who used to be in a Busch team with that number. But that's where we'll be. Back to Nick.
Thank you. We've got burnout for Scott. Burnout.
Okay.
Oh yeah. Pulling your face back.
All right, folks. Well, real quick, we got one more clip to play for you. But before we do that, let's head over to the beanbag.
Who's on the horn?
And see who's on the phone. Jamie, who's on the phone, darling?
We have Billy calling from Alki. And
hey,
you pull me in, Al? I'm so far from Billy. Al.
Oh. You want to bring the sand?
Yes, I'll
bring the beach to you?
He wants me to be closer. Can you pull me in just
you got to bring the beach to you?
I'm coming, baby.
He's bringing the sand.
Yeah.
He's bringing sand.
Hey, it's amazing
I'm coming,
that you have
baby,
enough.
Here I am.
Up here,
Al. He's got a ham up here. Down low.
He's a smart camera guy, isn't he?
What's going on, Billy?
Hey, how are you guys doing there?
Good, good.
How's Al guy?
Got to make it quick.
Oh, yeah,
it's
beautiful. Hey, Nick, you're looking great with all that ink there. Jamie, you're beautiful. A lot of bounce to the ounce.
Tony,
NASCAR Rocks, I got a question there for Iceberg or whatever his name is.
Yeah, the lettuce man.
Bigger than Ice Cube Iceberg.
Iceberg, that's like a head of lettuce.
How you doing there, Ice Tray?
Hey, good. Ice Tray, yeah.
Well, I just got a quick question.
Ice House.
You look like you work out there, guy.
A little bit.
Isn't he buff?
Well, you look like you work out a lot. I got a good question. I'm trying to work out a little bit, trying to fancy up for the girl, you know.
There you go.
You know, I'm trying to get a lot. Oh, Jamie, you're beautiful. You're
yes,
look
yes.
at those guns.
Yeah, look at that.
But Ice Tray, Sculpture, whatever you are there, you got any advice about steroids or some
yeah,
stuff
like
that?
Yeah, don't do it.
I heard
do
a lot about
as you
that.
Can.
Yeah, stay far away from them.
Stackables.
Don't do that. I've got
straw
advice
bead,
for you.
Cut.
Only do them if you're going to play ball.
Diana
sound
ball.
Sound like they can get away
Anna
with
ball.
It. Ball. You play baseball?
I'm going on 50 years old, and I'm, you know, my
no.
body's all
no.
out of shape.
You don't want
I
that,
well
dude?
Just do it.
No. Billy. Diet, cardio,
yep.
and easy on the weights, because at this point your ligaments and your bones aren't
yep.
what they used to be, especially with the calcium depletion. So the most important thing you can do is have a good diet, good healthy diet.
Stretch,
do a lot of
reps,
cardio, do a lot
reps.
Of cardio. Do a lot of lighter weights with high reps.
Yep.
And get yourself an MP3 player with some, like, Pantera.
But,
some
I mean, what if I
want
to get to the point where I look like Ice Dog there?
Yep.
Ice Dog.
Stay away from the
snow
juice.
Dog.
I've never touched the juice. I've only done protein, done a little bit of creatine here and there, and
that's it. Snow Cone, let me ask you this, Snow Cone. Is there any truth to the steroids there making your penis small?
Yeah,
well,
it really
I wouldn't
does.
Know because mine's the opposite. So I apparently that proves that I haven't. I've tried it. That's
yes.
why I have small hands.
Yes,
that.
It does. But if you've got a 14-inch cock and you know it shrinks it down to 10, you'll probably get a lot more dates because then girls.
Well, you know,
from
the rumor has it
murder.
That Iceberg there's got a really big cock.
Well,
is that what Nick told you?
Is that what's knocking on the table?
We can all have one if we want one. They sell them at the store.
That's a rumor down on Alki in West Seattle.
And they come in pink, blue, black, and white.
That's down on the beach.
You can't put it in the sand like an ostrich. I'll tell you that.
He'll wear a Speedo down there this weekend for you, Billy, so you can, you know, see it for yourself if you want.
Well, you tell him to drop on by with that big old thing, and we'll talk a little bit more about storage while he's stickering up my Barbie Jeep.
There we go.
Yeah, Billy, I stay away from that.
Right across from the volleyball nets, huh?
It can be dangerous.
Call back anytime,
man. And we'll walk across the street to the volleyball court, too, while we're at it.
All right, fellas. Well, it's been a pleasure talking to you. Thanks for your advice. Jamie, you're beautiful. You guys keep up the good work.
Thanks, man.
Hey,
thanks
get on a bike
you
and
you
ride.
Really.
Get on your bike and ride.
Good evening, y'all.
Good
Bye.
Evening, man.
And, you know, I've got one other piece of advice for people out there that do want to exercise that don't have a lot of time. Every morning, just wake up, set your alarm clock for 7 more minutes, do some stretching. By the time that 7 minutes is up, you'll want to work out, and you don't have to, and that's equivalent to a 30-minute exercise program in the afternoon.
Good job.
Day.
Okay, in the meantime, folks, real quick, here's the tattoo promo in case you didn't catch the beginning of the show. Take a look. We'll be back to say goodnight to you in just a few minutes. Hit it, fellas.
Good night. In a few minutes.
Go.
Dream called Yo Sun, which happens to be a week and a half block away from my very own tattoo shop.
Right on.
Saturday night. And they're going to help us a lot with celebrity presence.
Sorry, we got to cut that a little bit short because we're running out of time. As you can see, the credits are rolling. I want to thank the Iceman, Dave McFarlane, for joining us.
Thanks, Billy Badass, for the phone call from Alki. Brett, happy birthday.
Myself and probably the Prophet or some other co-host next week will be back along with Jamie and StockCar Scott and the rest of the crew. Thank all you freaks out there. Sorry we didn't get to talk about the All-Star Game, but do you really care? It sucks. I mean, it's just a shit.
Eat your own. End of story.
Enter the contest if you'd like. Email us, call us, the voicemails. We play the voicemails back if they're worth the crap. So, on behalf of everybody here on the Wateboys Sports Show, I'm your host, St. Nick Custalow. Load your tattoo freak daddy, baby. We'll see you next Thursday at 9 o'clock. Till then, y'all. Peace.